We're going to take a walkthrough of two different systems that Hutchinson Community College uses. The first one we will look at is DragonZone, which is our student information system. This is where you can pay your bill, register for a parking permit, and other similar things. The second system we will look at is LearningZone, which houses our courses. Most of the courses in LearningZone are online, but your face-to-face courses might use some components of LearningZone as well, such as the Gradebook. To access DragonZone, you will find a link on the main HutchCC website, but you can also get there quickly by typing in the URL dz.hutchcc.edu. You can then enter your login information to access the system. I am logging in as a test student. This contact information box will pop up the first time you log into DragonZone, and it will continue to pop up unless you update your information. So you can get rid of this by clicking the X, but if you want it to stop appearing, you would need to update your contact information and click Save. Let's first take a look at the dashboard and go to My Zone. You'll see a number of different buttons here, and you can actually customize which buttons appear on your dashboard by clicking Choose Links. Here you can select or deselect any of these options to choose what appears on your dashboard. You will notice the counter in the top right corner that tells you how many more links you are able to choose for your dashboard. When you're finished making your selections, you can return to My Links. You can also rearrange the buttons by clicking them and dragging and dropping. The two buttons that you cannot get rid of and you cannot rearrange are the Learning Zone and the Google Drive buttons. Those are made available to every student at all times. As a HutchCC student, you have unlimited storage in Google Drive. This means you can use Google Docs, Google Sheets, and other similar Google products for free and with unlimited storage. Let's click now on the Messages tab. This is one central area that tells you any messages you have in DragonZone, in LearningZone, and in your Gmail account, which is your official HCC email address. You will also see announcements in this area as well. The Alerts tab will display any alerts such as financial aid holds or library holds if you have those on your account. Messages and alerts also appear in the top right corner of DragonZone, along with a number badge that tells you how many messages or alerts you have. Now let's go back to the dashboard button and go to My Profile. You can update your contact and biographical information here, but I especially want to point out the Settings tab. Here you can allow a guardian to access certain information in your DragonZone account. To add access for a guardian, simply select their name from the drop-down menu, and then you can choose what types of items you wish for that person to be able to access. I would encourage you to explore some of the other options available in DragonZone, but the last thing I want to show you is resources and library services. Here you will find a math and writing tutoring services button. There are tutors available through our campus library during almost all hours that the library is open. They provide tutoring services online, over the phone, and in person. So please don't hesitate to get in touch with them to get the help you need to succeed at HCC. One last thing I want to mention is that there is an app for DragonZone, and it's available for both Android and iOS. All you need to do is go to the Google Play Store or the Apple Store and search for DragonZone. Now let's take a look at LearningZone, where you can access your online classes or the online components of your face-to-face classes. We'll go to the Dashboard button, click on My Zone, and click on the LearningZone button. Anytime you log into LearningZone, you will see the dashboard where you can access your courses easily. You can customize the course tiles by clicking on the Edit button. You can give your course a nickname, and you can change the color of the tile as well. These changes will only be visible to you. They will not change in your instructor's dashboard or on the dashboard of other students in your class. If you would like to see your classes in a different view, you can click this toggle button to see the recent activity stream. Here on the right, you will see a few different lists. The to-do list tells you any upcoming assignments in any of your semester courses. The coming up list shows you any assignments that are due in the next 7 days. The recent feedback displays any recent grades that have been added in your courses or any feedback comments your instructors have left on your assignments. You will also see a View Grades button, which allows you to view a list of your courses and your overall grades. If you then wanted to view the detailed gradebook for any given course, you would just click on the link for that course. No matter where you are at in LearningZone, the global navigation menu will always display on the left-hand side of your screen. To return to the dashboard, you have two options. You can either click the dashboard button or you can click the LearningZone logo. Both of those buttons will take you back to the dashboard. Clicking on the account button allows you to log out of LearningZone. It also allows you to access and edit your user profile. You can view your settings, and you can change your notifications. I would encourage you to customize the notifications that you wish to receive for different items in the course. A check mark means you wish to receive notification as soon as possible. The clock icon means you wish to receive a daily notification. The calendar icon gives you a weekly notification, and clicking the X means you do not want a notification for that item. As you can see, you can choose different notification options for different events in the course. There is no need to click a save button. Once you have edited a notification setting, it automatically saves. Let's go back to the global navigation menu and take a look at the courses button. Although you can access your courses from the dashboard, you can also access them from this area. If you wish to see all of your courses, you can click the All Courses link. This will show you your current, past, and future course enrollments. If you wish to have a course display on the dashboard with a tile, all you need to do is click the star next to that course. When a star is yellow, it means that course will be on your dashboard. If the star is white, it will not. So let's unselect this one and we'll select a couple more. And when we return to our dashboard and go back to the tile view, you'll see those changes. The calendar button in the global navigation menu will show you your global calendar. That means that every course in which you are enrolled will display on this calendar. If you wish to unselect a course from the calendar, just check the box beside the course name and it will either remove or you can add courses back to the calendar. You will also see an inbox button in your global navigation menu. This is your LearningZone course mail. This does not replace your HCC email address. This is a course messaging system. When you have any unread messages in your inbox, you will see a badge indicating the number of unread messages. On the left, you will see a list of all of your messages, and you can filter those messages by course or by things such as your unread messages, your starred messages, etc. To compose a new message, click this button. You can only send a message in LearningZone to an instructor or other students in the courses in which you are enrolled. So first you would select the course, then begin typing the person's name who you wish to send a message to, and then click on their name. You would add a subject, add your message here, and then click send. You will also see options to reply, reply all, file, and delete messages. The last option in the global navigation menu is the help button. When you click on that, you will see a pop-up box with a few different options. Probably the most commonly used options for students are the Ask Your Instructor a Question link and the Report a Problem link. When you click on Ask Your Instructor a Question, it's basically the same as using your LearningZone inbox. When you click Report a Problem, this allows you to get help from the Online Education Department at HCC or the IT Department at HCC. When you submit a ticket, it goes to both departments at the same time, so you don't have to decide which department you should be getting in touch with. To create your ticket, type a subject and a description. It's helpful if you can be as detailed as possible in your description, and it's also helpful if you click on the Submit a Ticket link from the page in LearningZone where you're experiencing the problem. It's also great if you can send a screenshot or even a short video explaining the problem or showing us what you're seeing. You would then select the level of urgency in this drop-down menu and click Submit Ticket. I'm going to return to the dashboard now and go into one of these courses. On the left, you'll see what's called the course navigation menu. You might have different links showing than what you see here. Instructors can customize the links that display to students in their courses, but for the most part, your HCC classes should have these links displayed. You can click this button with the three horizontal bars to either hide or show the course navigation menu. On the right-hand side of your course, you will see the same lists that we saw in the dashboard, except these are specific to this course. So rather than seeing all of your assignments that are due in any of your courses, these are just the assignments that are due in this course. You will also see a View Calendar link. Unlike the global calendar that we looked at earlier, which displayed all of your courses, when you click on the calendar from within a course, it only displays items for that one course. Again, you can select additional courses, but the default for the calendar from within a course is just to display that one course. Back on the course homepage, we'll take a look at the Get Started module. If you are taking a face-to-face course, you might only see a couple of items in the Get Started module. You will most likely see the link for the student orientation and the link for the syllabus. If you are taking an online class, however, you should see the entire Get Started module as it is displayed here. In our online courses, we have set some requirements on the Get Started module that require students to view or submit certain items before they can access the rest of the course. You will see here that you must view the schedule of assignments and submit the orientation quiz and introduce yourself before you can move on in the course. When I scroll down here to lesson one, you will see that it's currently locked and it says the prerequisite is the Get Started module. The purpose of this is to make sure that students are aware of the due dates in the course for the semester and to make sure that they are set up for success in that course. Let's take a look at the gradebook. When you click on grades from within a course, it's going to show you your grades just for this one course. A tool that you might find useful in the gradebook is what's called a what-if grade. This allows you to see what your final grade would be in the course depending on what grade you would get on an assignment that you have not yet submitted. As you'll see here, John's student has 3 out of 4 grades completed in the course. He has not yet submitted discussion forum number 1, but he could see how different grades would affect his total score. In this space here, enter a score to see how that would affect the overall grade. So if John were to earn 7 points on discussion forum number 1, it would drop his grade to a 90%. However, if he received 9 points on that discussion, his grade would be 95% overall. Let's click this revert button to go back to his original score. This can come in especially handy if a student wanted to find out what grade they had to get on a final exam in order to pass the class or a similar situation. If you're taking an online course, your instructor will definitely be using the gradebook in LearningZone. For a face-to-face class, using LearningZone is optional for the instructor. However, we strongly encourage instructors of face-to-face classes to use the gradebook at a bare minimum. So if you're in a face-to-face class and the instructor is not using the gradebook, feel free to request that of your instructor. If you have any questions about LearningZone, please don't hesitate to contact the Online Education Department. You can do that by clicking the Help button and reporting a problem, or you can visit us in Lockman Hall, and you can also email us at onlineed@hutchcc.edu. Have a great semester!